Hi, my name is Rob Zochowski, and I'm the Program Director of Faculty, Impact Investing, and Sustainability Special Projects at Harvard Business School. And I'm here to talk to you about the interplay between accounting principles and in the environment. In September of 2020, BP CEO Bernard Looney announced a major initiative to transition the 111-year-old company away from hydrocarbon-based energy by investing in and developing new renewable energy technologies. In the weeks following the announcement, the firm's stock fell almost 17% to a 25-year low and substantially trailed the sector returns. To some observers, this may seem like a counterintuitive result for a company presenting a comprehensive and preemptive strategic plan to transition the business to better address the needs of the coming economy. Not only is this plan protecting shareholders from market share erosion, given substantial moves by regulators and car companies globally, it represents a major step toward addressing the need to reduce GHG emissions to soften the climate emergency. However, this punishing result, for which Bernard Looney will likely feel substantial pressure, should not be surprising at all. It follows directly from the incentives of the current accounting system, coupled with the obsession with short-term profits. The current writing and the interpretation of the International Financial Reporting Standards, or IFRS, are rooted in an economy comprised of physical capital. However, this is a hallmark of a bygone manufacturing economic era. As many economies have transitioned toward delivering value through intellectual property, services, and technological know-how, collectively, examples of intangible assets, the accounting standards have failed to keep up. For example, developing intangible assets requires substantial technical knowledge, research, trials, and iterations. As a rule under US GAAP, and unless under very specific circumstances are met under IFRS, expenditures like these are expensed. KPMG notes that demonstrating the technological and technical feasibility required to meet the IFRS standard for capitalization is much harder to do for projects in which the company has little experience, and thus these are expensed through the income statements. These are precisely the types of projects in which BP will be embarking upon as it transitions its business model. By contrast, physical assets are generally biased toward capitalization, so long as an organization expects to derive future value from them, which means the investment in acquiring or building such assets is not included in the income statement and thereby does not impact net earnings. Again, returning to the example of BP, investing in new renewable energy production will require enormous amounts of investment in new technical and strategic expertise within the company, as well as research and strategy expenditures to explore implementation and improvements in known and undiscovered sustainable energy technologies, well before any physical assets are developed. And given the relatively high accounting burden for capitalization, most of the costs will go through the income statement, reducing income in the short term, despite long-term expected value of such investments. This leads to the compounding problem of short-termism. EY produced the Poland report on the challenges produced by short-termism, citing numerous studies that document reduced investment expenditures for fear of impacting quarterly dividends, even at the risk of reducing a company's long-term competitiveness. And lest one think that this relates to a minority of CEOs, a 2004 survey by Graham et al. Of 401 financial executives finds that 80% of respondents would cut spending on R&D, advertising, and maintenance. 50% would delay starting a new project, and 41% would turn down a positive NPV project altogether in order to meet an earnings target. The legacy accounting issues like these must be resolved if we are to remove fear of and disincentives against businesses transitioning to a more sustainable and environmentally friendly economy by allowing for the monetization of impacts and recognition of these as liabilities, as well as investment into new business models as assets. the current system greatly constrains companies' management teams in their decision-making, at risk to shareholder value, as well as planet, society, and the very future viability of their organizations. Thank you.